Hi students, welcome to my channel. Today the subject is a very common topic for quantitative aptitude session, that is for subject mathematics in all competitive exams, that is ACF and LCM. It is a common chapter for WBCS, PSC, SSC exams, bank and insurance exams like IBPS, SBI. So it is a general topic. Let us first starting with the basic concepts of ACF and LCM, and then we go through the problem based solution. I think you all are very known to the topic ACF and LCM from your school days. Now first we have to know what is ACF and LCM. HCF means highest common factor, What is highest common factor? Highest means highest common factor, that is common factor. If we choose to number 20 and 32, so factor of 20, that is the number by which 20 is exactly divisible, that is factor of 20, 1 is the factor of 20, so 20 is the factor of 20, because 1 20 20 or 21 20, 2 10 the 20 or 10 to the 20. Next 3 9 4 5 20. So factor of 20s are 1 2 4 5 10 and 20. Now the factor of 32, 1, then again 32, 2, then 16, 2 16 32, 4 8 32, 8. So 1 4 1 2 4 8 16 32. Now 1 is common to both, 2 is also common factor of both. Common means which is in general of 2, that is which is the factor of both 20 and 32. 4 also common. Now among these 3 common factors, 4 is the highest or greatest common factor. So HCF of 20 and 32 is 4. Again we can solve it 20 32 20 32. In field of competitive exam, 20 and 32, the ACF of them will be determined by such a way that we have to choose such a number by which 20 and 32 are exactly divisible. Both them are exactly divisible. So the number be 2 or 4, 4, 5, 4, 8. The common term 4 is the HCF. If we choose 6, 12, 16. So all three are divisible by 2. 2, 3, 6, 2, 6, 12, 2, 8, 16. But now 3 and 6 can be divisible by 3, but 8 is not divisible by 3. So there are no common factors between all three, among the all three. And so 2 is the 8th year. Again, we can also find HCF of two numbers by divisible rule. That is by divided method. 32, 20, 21, 20, 12. Again, 20 comes. 20, 12, 1, 12. 8, remainder 8, then again 12 is come, and then 8, 1, 8, 4. This process will be continue up to that 4 to 8. When it is exactly divisible, then the process should be stopped, and at that step, that is final step, the divider is the result, that is the HCF of 20 and 30. This is divisible method. I think you all are aware of this method from your childhood days. Now, what is LCM? What is LCM? LCM means least common multiple. Least common multiple. Why least? Because multiple, the number of multiples of any number is infinite. What is multiples? If we choose two numbers, that is 12 and 30. Their HCF becomes 4, and their LCM 12, this is HCF. HCF of them is 4, but LCM of them is, LCM of them, that is multiple of 12, that is 12, 24, 12, 1, 12, 12, 2, 24, 12, 3, 36, 12, 4, 48, 12, 5, 60, and so on. 32 का मल्टीपल क्या क्या है? 32, 32 to 64, 32, 3, 3 to 6, 3, 3, 9, 96, 32, 4, 34, 124 to 8, 128, 35, that is 35, 155 to 10, that is 160, 36, 36, 180, 6 to 12, 192, 32, 7, 32, 7, that is 73, 210, 730, 210, 72, 12, 224, 224, and so on. Now, the least common multiple, no one is common from this, and so we have to continue 60, then 12, 560, 12, 6, 12, 6, 72, 12, 8, 96. Now a common multiple comes out, and so 96, after 96 there are also common multiples of 12 and 32, but which multiple is common, which multiple is common and the highest common multiple, this is meaningless, because multiple is stretched to infinity, and so we can determine the least common multiple, that is 96. This is the least common multiple. least common multiple is 96. So 12 and 30 took a LCM 96. Now in field of competitive field, we can easily find out their LCM. First, 4. 2 or 4, by 2 or 4, they can be divisible. So 4 is the greatest factor. So 4, 4, 3, 12, 4, 8, 32. So the LCM, HCF is only 4, but LCM is 4 into 3 into 8, that is 4 into 3, 12, 12 into 8, that is 96. Common, the common number by which they are divisible, that is HCF. If we choose 20 and 60, then 2, 10, 2, 30, 4, 8, we also divide by 4, but in 2 steps, 2, 5, 2, 15, 5, 1, 5, 3. So HCF are the only common factors, that is 5 to 10 to 20. So HCF be 20, LCM 5, 2 to 4, 5, 20 and 3, 23, 60. So their LCM be 60 and HCF be 20. Pearson number, two given Pearson number, that is 12, 32 and 20, 60. HCF, that HCF be 4, HCF 20. LCM equal to 96, where LCM equal to 60. Now we see that LCM is always greater than the two numbers and also greater than the two numbers, but HCF is always less than the two given number. Now again we notice that 12 and 32 LCF 4, 12, 32 but HCF 4. Now 4 from HCF, if we go to the number again, 4 into 8, that is 32, 4 into 3, that is 12. So the numbers are the multiple of HCF. HCF, and these two numbers by which the HCF are multiplied, HCF is multiplied and we can back to the initial numbers. These two numbers must be coprime. These two numbers must be coprime. Coprime means 8 and there are no common factors between 8 and 3. That is, if you have given HCF of two numbers is 4, then you can say one number is 4x and other is 4, the other number is 4y, where x and y are two coprimes number, must be coprimes. Coprimes means between them there is no common factor, that is there is no common factor, that is that HCF must be 1, because 1 is common factor of, 1 is factor of every number. So when coprime means that HCF be 1, or so 8 and 3 are coprimes, coprimes or primes to each other, that is they have no common factor except 1, 1 is common, that is their HCF should be 1. So if again we can also see that number 1232, then HCF be 4, LCM 96. Now HCF into LCM equal to first number into second number, that is the multiplication of between the two given numbers are also the multiplication between HCF and LCM. That is HCF 4 into 96. 96 is chosen as 100. So 4 into it, that is, we can choose this 100 minus 4. So 4 into 100, that is 400 minus 16, 384. 384. Again, 12 into 32, 12 to 24, or 12 3 36, so 360. 12 into 30, 360, 12 into 2, 24, 384. So HCF into LCM equal to first number into second number. Next we go through the problem, some problems and their solution, how we can solve easily the HCF and LCM problems. Here, find the HCF problem number 1, that is, find the HCF and LCM of these three numbers are given. These are given in factorial form, factor form. That is, how we can find easily the HCF and LCM of them. HCF equal to first 2, 2 to the power 5, 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 2. So HCF should be the lowest power, that is 2 square. LCM must be the highest power, that is 2 to the power 5. Next. So next 3, 3 square, 3 cube, 3. So HCF must be 3. This is the smallest power. This is the smallest power, this is only 1, and LCM contains the highest power, that is 3 cube. Here 5, there are 5 square, here 5, so HCF is 5, because the lowest power is in 2, and so lowest power 5. Here 5 square, that is the highest power of 5. Again 7, here 7 to the power 0, here 7 to the power 3, here 7 to the power 1. So here 7 to the power 0, that is no 7, this contains no 7s, but HCF highest power, that is 7 cube. So this is HCF, this is LCM. Next. Problem number 2 tells that the ratio of two numbers each 5 is to 6 and their LCM is 480, then their HCF is. Now this problem is from SSC multitasking paper of the year 2013. Very easy problem. This is ratio of two numbers 5 is to 6. So we can tell that the numbers are 5x and 6x. Since 5 and 6 are coprimes to each other, then we tell that x is the HCF of them. Because in the previous section of my video, I tell you that HCF into two coprimes number gives back to the numbers. And so if 5 and 6 be the ratio of two numbers, so we can choose one number 5x, another 6x. So x must be the HCF of the two numbers, because x is common factor, since 5 and 6 are coprime, because 5 and 6 has no common factor except 1. So 5 and so HCF is x. Now LCM is 480, so HCF equal to x. We can now write this HCF into LCM, that is x into LCM, HCF into LCM, this is HCF equal to product of the two numbers, that is 5x into 6x. So x cancel out. Now 5 6 30 30, 30 is 0, 0 cancel out, 3 is 16, 48. So x equal to 16. So HCF